Hey, Mountain Church, I know you guys are connecting in your life groups and having a great time having communion with the Lord and having a meal together and just really being in community like we are called to do and loving each other. And as we do, we're getting in the Word too and talking about the Scriptures. And I want to read a story to you tonight that is one of my faves. And it's the parable of the vineyard workers, and it's in Matthew chapter 20. And just listen to this story. It's a profound story. It goes like this. Jesus is speaking and he says this: "The kingdom of heaven is like the landowner who went out early one morning to hire workers for his vineyard. He agreed to pay the normal daily wage and sent them out to work. At 9 o'clock in the morning, he was passing through the marketplace and saw some people standing around doing nothing. So he hired them, telling them he would pay them whatever was right at the end of the day. So they went to work at the vineyard, and at noon again and 3 o'clock, he did the same thing. At 5 o'clock that afternoon, he was in town again and saw some more people standing around, and he asked them, 'Why haven't you been working today?' And they replied, 'Because no one's hired us.' And so the landowner told him, 'Then get out and join the others in my vineyard.' Well, that evening, he told the foreman to call the workers in and pay them, beginning with the last workers first. And when those hired at 5 o'clock were paid, each received a full day's wage. And when those hired first came to get their pay, they assumed that they would receive more, but they too were paid a day's wage. And when they received their pay, they protested to the owner, 'Those people worked only 1 hour, and yet you've paid them just as much as you paid us, who worked all day in the scorching heat.' He answered one of them, 'Friend, I haven't been unfair. Didn't you agree to work all day for the usual wage? Take your money and go. I wanted to pay this last worker the same as you. Is it against the law for me to do what I want with my own money? Should you be jealous because I'm kind to others? So those who are last now will be first then, and those who are first will be last.'" Jesus just puts it out there and says, mind your own business. Mind your own business. Do what you're called to do, and don't be overly concerned with the mercy that is being extended to others. It was totally fair what this landowner did. It was totally merciful and gracious for him to give a full day's wage to those who only worked just the last part of the day. And those that were working all day, they got what they bargained for. It's such a great lesson for all of us. It's a great lesson for me not to be looking around saying, "Lord, why does that person have that talent and ability? Why do they are gifted in that way? Why don't I have what they have? What's the deal?" And the Lord's like, "Jim, because I've been gracious to somebody else in a different way doesn't mean that it's wrong or evil of me. You've been given so much. The fact that we live in a free country, the fact that we have the Word of God in our hands and friends around a table, even like in our life group, that alone is richness of life." And so I just, again, I love these parables of Jesus that just bring to home, you know, oftentimes a revealing of the heart of, you know, where am I at? Am I looking around and envious and jealous of what others have gotten or get or the blessings they have in their life? Or am I simply just thankful for what God's given me and realize, man, what I've got is way more than I deserve? So talk about that tonight. Talk about that in your life group. You know, how does that look? Are you thankful for what you have? Are there other things that others have that sometimes are a temptation to be envious of, you know? And at the end of the day, man, God has just been good to all of us. And so pray for each other as you guys rally together tonight, and we'll see you this weekend.